10,000 Volts is just a kick-ass rock and roll song, and I identify with it because I was electrocuted while I was on stage with Kiss in Lakeland, Florida. And that was one of the reasons I wrote Shock Me. And then me and Steve came up with 10,000 Volts. You know, I would say that 10,000 Volts is as good as the song Shock Me. The biggest difference between this album and past albums is the fact that I collaborated with Steve Brown from Trickster and Rubik's Cube. We just hit it off from the beginning. You know, when me and Steve collaborate, magic happens.
Making this record was one of the most incredible experiences of my life, working with somebody like Ace Frehley, the icon. He's the reason that I started playing guitar. Kiss is the reason that I started writing songs. Being a producer means that you have a big responsibility, and that is making your artist, Ace Frehley, be the best that he can be. And we did that on this record. I think the key of it all is the love of music. Somebody like Ace, who's been doing this, making records for 45 years, he still is a little kid at heart, and he still cares about making a great record.
Most rock musicians can't even read music. You know, it comes from within here. And I think this is the stuff that gets people. I've played it for a lot of people whose opinions I cherish and trust, and it's always the same reaction. This is some of the best songs you've ever written. I always felt that, you know, if you make a great record, the music speaks for itself.
Every song on this record is great. And one of the greatest things, I think, which the fans are really gonna notice, when they hear this, they're gonna be like, wow, it's everything that you loved about Ace Frehley from the 70s and the 80s, but brought into 2023 with the best production he's ever had. You're gonna hear things on this Ace Frehley record that you've never heard on an Ace Frehley record.
All I can say is I know that I love this record. I believe my fans are gonna love it. And I can't wait to perform some of these songs live because they kill.